Oh, God. Okay, well, that lightning was just an unfortunate coincidence. Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back. Let me just double check where I'm going that way. Welcome back to Outlast. Morris here once again, your host for this playthrough. And I hope you're enjoying this playthrough, ladies and gentlemen, because I have to say, if I wasn't doing this as a playthrough, I don't think I'd be doing this at all. You know, this game has made... We're only... What is this? Episode 7? Only 7 episodes in. And I'm just thinking, there's no way I'd be doing this by myself. You know, this game is making me... This game... I was thinking about this, right? I was thinking about this before I went to bed last night. Because I knew I'd have to record some more of this. And I was just thinking... Why do we... What's following me? What's following me? Oh. Is anything following me? What's everywhere? Oh my god! Why do we play scary games? Why do we do this? Post a comment. Let me know in the comments below why you play scary games. Because... what is that? I don't even want to see it. Oh god, this is bad. This is so bad. I didn't expect this to be happening so soon. Okay. That's really close. That is close. I can hear it. Whatever it is. I'm going in circles. Because, you know, I don't know why I play scary games. I mean, Oh my god. I don't really play that many scary games. You know? I mean, there is Resident Evil, and that's... sort of scary, but you always regain a bit of control, you know, because you can defend yourself. But I mean, we've spoken about it before, in this game there is no defending yourself, as you can see right now, you know, and that changes a lot, because this game is like a bad dream. Can you hear me? Can you hear the quivering in my own voice right now? I'm trying to sound confident, but I'm not. This game's like a bad dream, because I used to have a lot of nightmares when I was a kid. I'm wasting battery life here. I used to have a lot of nightmares when I was a kid. Because, you know, when... Oh, God. He's got me. So I used to play a lot of games as a kid. You have an imagination. Oh, God, no. Well, that's the first death. There it is. Don't quite know how to get out of that. But yeah, this is, I used to have a lot of nightmares when I was a kid. Overactive imagination, plus playing video games. I mean, what do you expect? I used to dream of all sorts of crazy things. But the worst dream, and please let me know if you've had this dream, and I'm sure you have had, because I believe that everybody has. The worst dream is when you're being chased by something, right? You're being chased by something, there's nothing you can do. Can I not? I can't even try and open that. There's nothing you can do, you're being chased, you can't get away. You know, there's no escaping it. Something's gonna keep gaining on you, you know? And there's no defending yourself from it either. Because, you know, you're a kid, and kids can't really defend themselves against all that much. I certainly couldn't. I mean, I can defend myself against very little now, you know, so as a kid I really had no chance, and that's what this game is like. Oh, you go up here. I should have known it'd be something to do with this. Can I shimmy along here? Yes, I can. So that's what I'm kind of equating this game to right now. But the thing is, the best thing is these days, I don't dream nearly as much, and I don't have bad dreams nearly as much. But when I do, I find it a lot more fun. It's a lot more of a thrill ride, you know, when you have bad dreams these days. Oh god, that was not the smooth landing I expected. I kind of jumped over the dumpster. Okay, can we get inside? I actually think inside was safer. Oh god. Oh, a battery. Can I? Please? Can I? Please. Thank you. That's handy. But yeah, these days, you have bad dreams. It's kind of funny because you can defend yourself, you know? Because, you know, I'm a guy. I'm a man now, you know? I'm not a kid. At least that's what I keep telling myself. So if something bad happens, then you can fight back, and it's a little bit more interesting. It's a little bit more exciting. But this is like going back to those old days of I can't do anything. Because I'm a huge baby! Oh, God. Okay. As evidenced by what you just saw. Hey, dude, I'm gonna go around this tree. I'm gonna do the old alley-oop. And now I need to reload. And I hope... Oh, okay. Nearly. Oh, God. What's crouch? Oh, God. Okay. Find Father Martin. Okay. Well, I'll try and do that. But yeah, I mean, this is one of the strangest playthroughs I've ever done on this channel. Because, you know what? Years ago, I made a YouTube channel. I did. I made one. You're looking at it right now. And I said, well, what do I want to do? I want to play some games. I'll play some video games. It seems to be an emerging trend. Lots of people seem to be doing that. I play games. I talk about games. I think you should maybe do that. Make a channel about that, right? Makes sense. And I said, I'm going to talk about those games while I'm playing them. Oh, nope, we're making a note. So much blood in the water, I can smell it. Like putting a penny in your mouth when you were a kid. I don't remember doing that. The whispers are making more sense. I'm looking for static, it's like an itch. Okay. But yeah, I said I'm going to talk over those games and maybe offer some opinions. I said, well, what do I want to achieve with it? What's the point of that, right? Do I want it to be funny? Well, I guess I do, but at the same time, that's not the primary concern for me, you know? I think a lot of channels these days are very concerned with not being funny, you know? So they kind of overexert themselves to be hilarious. But I mean, I don't want to talk too much about that. But what I said to myself was, I kind of want to offer an opinion, you know? I kind of want to look, because... I kind of, for me, it's never enough to say that something is good or bad. You know, I don't think you can go and see a film and say that was a good film and leave it at that. I think you always have to examine why. I'm always interested in the why. You know, the subtext, the reasons behind it.
You saw the Wall Rider, didn't you? You're beginning to understand, but not yet. Even Abraham had to cast his eyes to the ground. But soon, soon, this way, revelation is at hand.
Okay, whatever you say, Father Martin, I'm with you. But yeah, so I'm always interested in the reasons why, and it's the same with games, really. So I said to myself, well, if I can get people thinking, you know, if we can examine what's working in games and what isn't. Even if I just, you know, you don't have to agree with everything I say, but I'm a very sort of opinionated person. I think that's pretty obvious by now. We've known each other long enough. I'm sure that must have come across by now. Is that a dude? Oh, God. Okay, well, it was a dude. Not anymore. So, yeah, if I can, you know, you don't have to agree with me, but if I can get people thinking about other things, about different opinions... and get you guys examining why it is that you like particular games, then that's, you know, that's the reason why I do this stuff. But honestly, with this game, I haven't had a fucking second to myself to even consider what the hell is working and what isn't. I've just been running through blindly, mostly. Without knowing what the hell's going on. I don't know where I am in relation to where I've been right now. I don't know what the hell's going on. I don't know what the hell's coming up right now. I seem to be consistently low on battery life these days. Which is not good. So yeah, this is a tough one for me. I haven't had a moment to talk about what's good and what isn't. I'm just trying to get out of here. As quickly as I can. Oh my. Ugh. I hope I haven't, oh god, I'm gonna... Oh, that's a battery. I hope I haven't, you know, gone through this game too carelessly with my battery usage. Because it would be a real shame to get to the end of this, or get towards the end of this, and be out of batteries completely. I don't want to have to brute force my way through this stuff. Oh god. It's just, it's getting ridiculous now. It's just complete. Oh god, why do some lights work and some don't? What's happening? Oh god. Okay, I'm stressed out. Is that obvious? Is it obvious I'm stressed out? Hey dude. I don't have time to look at you. I don't have the battery life to look at you. Oh, the old classic wheelchair on its side with wheel spinning. Actually haven't seen that so far. It's a miracle he could walk after all. Okay, it said use the upper floors to get to Father Martin, so why the hell are we going down? That just seems counterproductive. Aha! Okay, upper floors, here we come. Okay, well... I guess it had to be that way. So what, do I have to go down to get an elevator to go up? That sounds like a horror game to me. Ugh. God, my throat is dry right now. Just from being in this situation. But it's interesting, I mean, one thing that, just while we're not being chased, I will try and get this out. Because again, I have been thinking about it. But one thing that happens with horror games when you play them, and I do this to myself, and I shouldn't, but sometimes we go through them very slowly, right? Can I hide? No. There's no hiding under there. Oh god, give me this. Oh god. Sometimes we go through very slowly, and we sort of create our own tension, right? And by doing so, oi! We make it way scarier than it needs to be, right? Are you gonna be hostile or not? Okay. Oh god, god. This is breathing time. This is breathing time. Referencing Nazi War Crimes Disclosure Act. Well, this'll be interesting. The first paperclip provides a means of obtaining services of foreign specialists for specific assignments within the technical services of the Departments of Army, Navy, and Air Force. Project 63 is primarily a denial program with utilization as a desirable feature. The aim of this program is to secure employment in the United States of certain preeminent German and Austrian specialists, thus denying their services to potential enemies. Okay, I'm not sure what that's about. But yeah, so we go through these games creating our own tension, and in doing so we make it way scarier than it has to be. But what this game does... Oh god! Oh god! Why did I not predict this would happen? Okay, that was my fault. That was my fault. I got in his personal space, and I don't like it when that happens to me, so I should have known better. That's fine, I guess. Hang on a second. Hang on a wee second. Why do I have two full batteries suddenly? I thought I only had one when I came through here. Now I have three. Oh, this is good. We could abuse this. We could die over and over again and just get 10 batteries. But yeah, what this game does is just seems to be the complete opposite. And it's very effective. Because I'm constantly moving. I constantly have to move in order to make progress. So there's no time to create my own tension. But in doing so, there's more opportunities for the game to go, whoa, and, you know, just throw something out there at you. Oh, that battery's not there now. What is going on? Okay, I got that done. You know what? There's nothing else down here, so what the hell am I doing down here? See you later, buddy. I just realized I didn't put my little timer on, so I have no idea how long this episode is going to be. Oh, another one. Thank you, sir. Okay, so we can't go upstairs. We've been downstairs, so we've got to go back through here, I guess. Oh, that's right. I forgot I had my fingers chopped off. Bah! Hello. No one. Huzzah! No one. Now then, this is a horror game, so there may be something in the toilet. Somebody may have left batteries in there. Nope. Okay. Useless. Nothing. It's a completely useless room. There are no hiding places around here. Wait, where did I just come from? Did I come from here? Yes, I did. Ugh. And that's another thing, I guess. Because you're constantly moving, it's a lot more difficult to kind of drum the layout of a place into your head. I have no map to work off, I just gotta move constantly. So you're never settled in this. Oh, God, okay. This is, what is this? Brief introduction to All Rider mythology. This is for support / notational purposes only. Engage in no direct contact with patients during or after therapy. The Wall Rider, also known as Alp, Mara, or Shrat, is a demonic creature. I'm shratting myself right now. Is a demonic creature of German origin that torments sleepers. They crouch on a sleeper's chest and crush the breath from him. The sleeper wakes terrified, paralyzed, and asphyxiating. The name Mara gives us the word nightmare. It's funny how we're talking about having nightmares, and suddenly we're into this. Sexual assaults by the demon are rare, but it has been known to drink milk from the breasts of sleeping women, and blood from the nipples of sleeping men. Well, that's... well, everybody's losing out there, aren't they, really? I mean, does it have to go so far? Oh, stairs are gone. What? Who's destroying all the stairs? Is that also a thing? Destroying stairs is also a rare occurrence, but it has been known to do that. Okay. Okay, it's pitch black. It's pitch black. I can't see anyone, and I'm running low on batteries, but we gotta just remember that those lockers are there. Make a note in your journals, ladies and gentlemen. You know, I have a little notebook that I use. You know, sometimes I... Ooh, battery. I didn't notice. Sometimes I've had it for years. I don't really use it that often, but, you know, I jot down ideas and thoughts and little things, but I just want to make a note of something. I don't normally do it on my phone. I like to put pen to paper. So I've had this notebook for years, and I was flicking through it, and it's so funny going back through old notes, because I have all kinds of, like, passwords and, like, number combinations, and, like, on one page, right in the very corner, it just says psychic/fairy in a circle. And so obviously I was playing Pokemon, and I just felt the need to write down psychic/fairy. I have no idea what it was referencing. I just find it funny to go through those old things. Okay, where the hell am I going? There's all kinds of hiding places, but not many progression places. So what are we doing? What's the POA here? Is there anything? Can I shimmy up the... No. No way. Okay. Oh, that's the same room. Oh god, now there's something in my eye. That's not good. Okay, all of this can't have been optional. There's gotta be something around here. Stairs this way. Okay, it's literally pointing me the right way to go. So I thought this area was useless. Is it actually? Yep. Oh, well, maybe there's a vent or something I can jump into. It's fine, that's one of the trickiest things in games to actually do, is to make a player look up.
Oh god!
Yeah, that's really bad for you. God, you're hiding some stairs. Can you not just let me in? I need those. God, there's a door right here. Can I not just smash through it? Alright, well, I'm a little stuck here. Can't... Well, I said I couldn't go up, but maybe there's something. Can I not, Can I not make that jump, maybe? Oh, yeah, he can make it. Let's be honest, we don't do a lot of platforming in this game, so I kind of forgot that that was a thing. But there you go. Can I hide? Oh, I can. I can hide. I feel like as long as I can hide, then it's fine. This door needs a key. Why do they always need a key? You can cross from the upper floor. Thanks. Why don't you just come to me, seeing as you know your way around? And then you can show me where to go. Don't you walk away. God damn it. I find that logic is never very present in horror games. Do we have anything? Oh god. Anybody? Anybody here? So yeah, I apologize for anybody watching this and thinking, well, maybe we'll get some interesting observations on the nature of... Bloody hell, what are you doing there? The nature of horror games and how Outlast contributes to that genre. I apologize. There will be none of that. There will just be me running away screaming. But I always wonder how I would actually react in a horror situation. Because when things make me... You know, when things make me jump scares, I don't... You know me, I'm not a screamer. I don't scream. You know? I kind of yell swear words. So I feel like if I was actually in a situation where even if there was a monster, like a mythical being, it wouldn't be very... It wouldn't be a very... Whoa, my... Like, it wouldn't be a great situation. It wouldn't be a very cinematic situation. It wouldn't be a big Hollywood scream. It would just be a really sort of gritty, horrible selection of swear words that I would throw at this monster. Alright, the last time there was a guy in a wheelchair, he totally jumped out at me, so... You know what? I'm gonna run towards you with my eyes closed, and then we'll see what happens, right? Eyes are closed. Am I there? Yep, I'm there. Okay. And there's no one. Right. Don't get up. I'd be really mad if you get up. Oh, precious batteries. Two at once. Why are you spoiling me? What are you preparing me for? Oh, God. Oh, God. There's a guy. There's a dude. And he's running. Well, he was running towards me. I have every right to run away. Right? I hate that they don't make much noise. Oh, God. God, what time are we on? We're not done with this episode yet. Crap! Ow! Oh, God, I shivered when that hit me. That's how badly I felt that. Remember where to hide. Can they climb over things? No, yeah, they can't they? Let's just regroup. Wait, what am I scared of? This isn't a unique enemy. This is just a dude with a crowbar. I can beat this. What can you do to me, really? Other than clearly hit me with a crowbar. But I could do the old alley-oop around the table. Okay, there's no way he went this far back this quickly. Well, something's happening down here. Pray for revelation. Oh! Hey dude, are you hostile? Probably, if I get too close. Picked up fuse for the- Oh god! Hey buddy! Ow! That hurt. My spine. We're running. We're not stopping. Never stopping. What did I pick up? The fuse for the laundry chute. Okay, I haven't even friggin' seen a laundry chute, so I don't know what that's for. Eh, you're not gonna come down here. This is my zone. Can't I just pick the lock or something? Alright. Alright, we don't know where the laundry chute is, but I'm sure that's not gonna be a problem. There's nothing down here, is there? Nope. So I've been smacked about a bit with a crowbar, but that's fine. Miles is a tough guy, you know? These journalists, they can be tough. Wait, did I go through here? Holy crap, this place is beat up. Really badly. What's happening? Please not the big guy. Please not the big guy. Please not the big guy. What is going on in here? Why am I in here? Why did I interrupt? Ugh. Okay. Well, what do we got? We got another fuse. Oh god, get underneath. Oh. Did you see me? Nah, you didn't see. You didn't see nothing. Drive in the nails. Eh, I don't think I will. Hi there, you can totally see me. Oh, I'm glad I came in here, because that, if we need two fuses, I would never have stumbled back across this. This was an accident. Okay, well, he's gone. I want to take a look at this. How are you like... Oh, it's a cross. I was going to say, how did they make him... Like, was that rigor mortis or something? But no, he's... Yeah. An upside-down crucifixion. Well, you know what? You get 10 out of 10 for originality. That's... I haven't seen that before. Can't I, like, take his belt and wrap it around my hand? You know, then I could give him a swift right hook. Not that they'd feel it, I don't think, but... It would feel good to me, you know? Driving the nails. Alright, what do we got? So now we got two fuses. So, I don't know where the laundry chute actually is. This is back where I came. Fuck me. Fuck it all. Does he have, like, a hard limit on where he's willing to go? Because I'm feeling this desk might be my savior. If I can just lure him here. Hey, dude. Dude. Where you at? Oh, there's lockers here as well. Hey, buddy. Come on, let's go. Let's go. Let's play. Let's play the game. Let's go. See, now I'm on his... I'm beating him on his terrain. I mean, that's pretty impressive. What do we got in here? Anywhere to hide? Anywhere at all? Nope. Is that a battery? Ow! Oh, come on, I'm in here, dude. I'm in here. Just play fair. I actually feel that when he hits me. Is that weird? Like, he hits me and I feel like I shiver. That's... Ugh. I've never felt that before. Alright, well, we just gotta keep running then. Hey, how you doing, buddy? How you doing? You okay? Everything's still good in here? Good. I'm glad. I'm glad everything's good. Wow, you're all just fighting over each other, aren't you? Okay. Well, I don't know where the laundry chute is, then. I think I need to go back to base camp. I think that's the only way to do this. Yeah, the music totally stops when I go back out of here. Still needs a key. Where is the laundry chute? Where would that be? Can't get in there. Alright. I don't really have time to sit and inspect everything. A fuse? I have two of them. So where are these guys doing their laundry? Come on. You know what? I'm taking a look at my audio, and it's around about 30 minutes, so hopefully I've been recording for 30 minutes. But yeah, I'm going to have to pause it for now, guys. But thank you very much for watching this episode of Outlast. I'm going to try and find this laundry chute, and then we will resume shortly. And I will see you there, guys. See you in a little while. You know what? Let's go under here. Safe.